the truth at 17. Life was meant for beauty queens and those of us with grabby spaces lacking in the social graces.
White Trash Debutantes, Ginger Coyote.
Oh, yes, I'm not going to say anything on TV about that.
Ginger is not just an individual. Ginger is an idea. And when you experience ginger, you've experienced life.
Really? Wild women don't die, they just dye their hair and get wilder. There were a lot of people that were sick of disco and wanted to get back live music. There had to be something else than going to, you know, discos and doing poppers and stuff. And I think the live punk movement was the answer to it.
But since we've met, we've always had like a surreal thing, but.
And wild adventures too.
Wait, let me tell you why I love you. You just hush for 1 minute, for one time. Let me just say that.
Well, I think Patti Smith's song, Outside of Society, that's where I want to be, pretty much sums it up. You know, about everybody that's an outcast. And that's what the punks were. And so they were accepting of people that had been outcast.
These rednecks at that time, they'd jump out of their car and come here trying to run, you know, they'd run at you and try to, you know, beat you up, all kind of things like that. But we used to stay one step ahead of them.
Oh, it's changed a whole lot. Oh, San Francisco has changed. You know, we've had this huge gentrification.
The 80s was a climate of complete conservative, you know, lots of yuppies, especially if you're in San Francisco.
There was a lot more violence in what was going on in Los Angeles than there was in San Francisco.
Early 80s, the skinheads, they kind of went beyond Broadway and they started like sucking up shows for a lot of people.
But around the country, you saw these regional scenes spring up, and on the West Coast, I mean, New York and Atlanta and Athens.
My first show was The Mentor.
We had done two shows in San Francisco, and then we went to New York and played CBGB's, and had Skip Baders, Joey Ramone, Cheetah Chrome, Lemmy Kill My Soon, Daniel Ray in the audience, of course. So that was not intimidating in the least bit.
But with punk, I think what it is, and it goes with metal too, it's all in and rock and roll, the outside of points.
You have to take the hate they throw you and make something good from it. Because the more hate they throw people like us, they're actually doing us a favor because they're making us stronger and more committed and willing than ever for us just to be ourselves.
This is how I met Ginger Coyote. I had never been to Eugene, Oregon before.
We go in and guess what? It's the White Trash Debutantes on tour. So I'm thinking, okay, cool. This sleepy little town of Eugene, Oregon. This is what I'm thinking because I'm used to Hollywood, right?
And when we were down in LA and you had that stick and you're like, come on, let's see who... are you man enough holding that? She's crazy. I thought we're going to get mugged, but then I look at her with that big bag and I'm like, nah, I'm safe.
You know, that we got arrested, we got harassed by cops and stuff like that.
And just completely shocked the hell out of everyone. I mean, naked people jumping around on stage. I'm not kidding, it was crazy. And I was like, in love right away. Just like, this band is nuts.
Now, if you were interviewing me, what would you ask?
What's your favorite word in the world?
What's my favorite what?
Word.
Yes.
I did drag as Divine, and she has someone corner me and said, what's your drag name? I said, Darla. Now wherever I go, I'll be walking into somewhere, and I'm going to be there with social distortion or, you know, some name fans. Darla! You know.
Did you do a John Waters movie?
Oh, yeah.
Don't you love him?
Yeah.
We're still brought me now.
Have the tenacity to also keep up punk low for 38 years. You know, started, you know, if she truly is punk rock, it's like...
She allows people who need the publicity or who need the exposure to get exposed in punk low. And I think that's something very different from a lot of the magazines.
Ginger will say anything to anybody. You know what I mean? Like, Ginger, like, we have a big black dildo.
I think it also has a lot to do with my sun sign, Libra, being harmonious and balanced.
I think it has nothing to do with being Libra. Have you met other Libras?
Yeah. Sharon Osbourne.
Oh, wait, I was thinking Leo. There's the one who's have close eyes.
Yeah, they're very egomaniac. Yeah.
Okay. And Ginger will pick like the biggest, most buff, eyesight shirt wearing, straight ass looking dude in the audience, and somehow sit on his lap and get him to suck that dildo. And every time she does it, I think, we're gonna die. We're gonna die. I gotta fucking go out there. I can't leave her out there alone. I'm gonna die, but yeah, guess that's a good way to go.
Oh, Miss Carol. Miss Carol's torture chamber, yeah.
This is the first time I've met Ginger Coyote. We're sitting at a table, and this freak show happens.
My dad is Ed Asner, and he was probably one of the biggest stars in television at the time.
I give a lot of credit to the kids that are really trying their best to find out what punk rock really is. Because what punk rock really is basically somebody saying, fuck you, not gonna tell me what to fucking do.
It was an amazing time. My dad sat in the audience and was offered Coke. And he said he'd like to stick to the liquor.
Playing it loaded, and I was on my way home. I see Ginger struggling with her groceries, walking home as well. You know, she had a Dr. Pepper 12-pack right here.
Ginger's herself. That's what makes her special. And Ginger never forgets anything. So everything.
I think Ginger and I have been. Had like a cosmic connection for many, many years, and we didn't know.
It could be an animatronic statue of Ginger that says, "Welcome to Hollywood, I'm Ginger Coyote."
Remember you asked me to your senior prom.
I do remember that. I do, but you didn't come.
Have you never seen Bewitched?
No.
Bewitched is the best, watch it. And they go, "You're serious, Mom? Come on in. No charge."
That was great. That was funny. That guy was, he was assuming that the aliens were coming and stuff, or?
Oh, he was funny, too.